burn marks.
These weren't here.
You must have spent a whole case of ammo holding this site.
Suppose that means we missed all the fun. No one's gonna move on this place now that the Pridwin's in town.
Paladin Dance is waiting for you inside, recruit.
We've got the airport ruins secured. The perfect staging area for our assault.
Cavalry's arrived. And it looks like they sent in the big guns.
Why did the Brotherhood send it here?
We call our ship, the Pridwin. She's loaded with enough troops and supplies to mount a major offensive. If she's here, Elder Maxon's here. And that means we're going to war.
Who's Elder Maxon? He's a dangerous man, that's what he is.
Maxon is the commander of this division of the Brotherhood of Steel.
He's the model of what every Brotherhood soldier hopes to become. If we're going to war, I can promise you that he'll be leading the charge.
That being said, you're about to get to know the Pridwin up close and personal. I've received orders that we're both to report to her immediately. Follow me up to the roof of the police station. We're going for a little ride.
It's so exciting being new to the Commonwealth. There must be so much technology out there that our scribes haven't seen yet.
If it looks dead, put one more in its head for good measure. Why take the chance?
Permission granted. Welcome back, Paladin. Allow me to be the first to congratulate you on a successful mission. And is this our new recruit?
Yes, sir. I field promoted her to initiate, and I'd like to sponsor her entry into our rankings personally.
Yes, we've read your reports. You'll be pleased to know that Elder Maxon's approved your request. Place the recruit in your charge.
Thank you, sir. And my current orders?
You are to remain on the Pridna and await further instructions.
Very good, sir. Ad Victoriam, Captain.
Ad Victoriam. So, you're the one Paladin Dance has taken under his wing. You don't look much like a soldier to me.
Then what's a soldier supposed to look like?
A soldier is supposed to be an efficient killing machine. Not a relic from the past playing catch-up with the rest of the world. If Dance hadn't stepped in and vouched for you, we wouldn't even be having this conversation. Accepting outsiders like yourself has proven disastrous in the past. I've read Paladin Dance's reports. He seems to think you'll make a fine addition to the Brotherhood. You might expect an endorsement like that to grant you a great deal of latitude with us. But let me make one thing clear. The Brotherhood of Steel has traveled to the Commonwealth with a specific goal in mind. As the captain of this vessel, I won't allow anyone to jeopardize our mission, no matter how valuable they think they are. Understood?
What exactly is your mission here?
I'm not at liberty to say. Elder Maxon will be addressing the crew shortly. And I'm certain all of your questions will be answered. Now, was there anything else? Or was everything I said understood?
Not even a hint? Come on, I deserve it.
Look, all I can tell you is that we're here directly in response to the data that Dance's recon team provided us. Beyond that, you'll just have to wait until Elder Maxon addresses the crew. Now dispense with the questions. It's time to get to work. Understood? That's all for now, soldier. Your orders are to proceed to the command deck for the address, after which Elder Maxon wishes to have a word with you. If you have any questions, ask me now. Otherwise, you're dismissed.
Can you tell me anything about Elder Maxon?
Elder Maxon is the supreme commander of the Brotherhood. Without his tenacity and his vision, we'd still be a small group of complacent stragglers, occupying the Citadel and the Capital Wasteland. In a mere decade, he's grown the Brotherhood of Steel into a major military force. He's an inspiration to us all. Is there anything else?
Yeah. Where can I get power armor?
Only knights are allowed to wear Brotherhood power armor. And you're no knight. Not yet. Until Elder Maxon grants you that title, you'll have to make do with what you've got. Anything else?
What are my orders?
Your orders are to proceed to Elder Maxon's address. After which he wishes to speak with you. Anything else?
I don't have any questions.
Then I suggest you head over to the command deck immediately. Dismissed, initiate.
Excuse me.
I can't talk to you right now. Maxon is preparing to address the crew.
You lost. Maxon's address is being held on the command deck.
Welcome aboard. Elder Maxon is holding his address inside the command deck.
Brothers and sisters, the road behind has been long and fraught with difficulty. Each and every one of you has surpassed my expectations by rapidly facilitating our arrival in the Commonwealth. You have accomplished this amazing feat without a hint of purpose or direction. And most impressively, without question. Now that the ship is in position, it is time to reveal our purpose and our mission. Beneath the Commonwealth, there is a cancer known as the Institute. A malignant growth that needs to be cut before it infects the surface. They are experimenting with dangerous technologies that could prove to be the world's undoing. For the second time in recent history, the Institute's scientists have created a weapon that transcends the destructive nature of the atom bomb. They call their creation the Synth, a robotic abomination of technology that is free-thinking and masquerades as a human being. This notion that a machine could be granted free will is not only offensive, but horribly dangerous. And like the Atom, if it isn't harnessed properly, it has the potential of rendering us extinct as a species. I am not prepared to allow the Institute to continue this line of experimentation. Therefore, the Institute and their synths are considered enemies of the Brotherhood of Steel, and should be dealt with swiftly and mercilessly. This campaign will be costly, and many lives will be lost. But in the end, we will be saving humankind from its worst enemy. Itself. Ad victorium!
Ad victorium! Ad victorium!
I care about them, you know.
Long.
The people of the Commonwealth.
I'm glad making a difference out here.
Care about them? I thought we were preparing for war.
The Brotherhood is here to prevent a war. By starting one of our own. The difference is, our war won't reduce civilization to ashes.
What do you want from me?
I want you to start taking responsibility for this planet. To start making a difference. And from what I've read in Paladin Dance's reports, you've already begun that journey. Seeing as he's one of my most respected field officers, you couldn't get a better recommendation. Therefore, from this moment forward, I'm granting you the rank of knight. And, befitting your title, we're granting you a suit of power armor to protect you on the field of battle. Wear it with pride.
Only a knight? Why not a paladin, like Dance?
The Brotherhood maintains a strict hierarchy, organized by rank. Paladin is several ranks above knight, and it took Dance many years to achieve that goal. With your continued loyalty to the Brotherhood, I'm certain you can attain the same. In any event, once you're finished becoming familiar with the Pridwin and my staff, report to the flight deck for your new orders. Welcome aboard the Pridwin, soldier. Make us proud.
Elder Maxson?
Take some time to familiarize yourself with the ship. Then meet me on the flight deck for your mission. Take some time to familiarize yourself with the ship. Then meet me on the flight deck for your mission.
Status report.
Green across the board, sir. Nothing new.
Good. Carry on, Knight. Congratulations on the promotion, Knight.
Proctor Ingram said she needed this suit tested yesterday.
Yeah, I get it. Just... what if I miss?
Don't.
Okay, sure. Firing. Everything holding together?
Trust me, you'd know.
Good. Firing!
Alright, alright. Everything looks nominal. And you didn't scuttle the ship. Thanks, Initiate.
Sure. Anytime.
Paladin Dance.
There you are. How did it go with Elder Maxson?
Maxson seems so young compared to everyone else. You're okay with that?
Don't let his age fool you. Maxson's a brilliant tactician, a formidable warrior, and possesses an idealistic vision for the future of the Brotherhood. I'd follow him anywhere, without question.
Why are you so confident in his abilities?
A decade ago, the Brotherhood had almost gone completely astray. The Elder before Maxson sent us down a path that was leading nowhere. He was more concerned about charity than the preservation of technology. But when Maxson took over, he single-handedly reprioritized the Brotherhood from the ground up and put us back on the path to glory. This ship and its crew are a testament to his leadership.
I was very impressed with him. He seems to know what's best for everyone.
Exactly. Without his determination, we'd be lost. I just hope you appreciate how much of a chance I'm taking bringing you into the fold this quickly. Not to put too fine a point on it, but if you screw up, we go down together.
So, what's all this about you being my sponsor?
Elder Maxson is understandably particular when it comes to new recruits. He believes in order to keep the Brotherhood strong, we have to bond as brothers. As your sponsor, It's my duty to travel with you throughout the Commonwealth to ensure that our ideals are being observed. That's why I'm so concerned about your performance in the field.
I won't let you down, Dance. I promise.
Good. Now, I know you're eager to hop into a suit of power armor and take the fight to the Institute. But first things first. In order to be an effective part of the team, you need to learn your way around this ship and get to know its crew. Since I've been officially assigned to you as your sponsor, I'd recommend taking me along with you.
Do you need to come with me now?
It might help if I tagged along with you. On the other hand, you might want to make your first impression without a paladin standing over your shoulder. It's up to you.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Outstanding.
Worried about these recruits. Gone too green. Like the initiative.
There's no time to waste when there's work to be done.
I'm proud to be serving under Elder Max.
Try it now.
Nothing. I was supposed to report 10 minutes ago. If you can't fix it.
I can fix it. You're the one who decided to kick your way through a mire lurk. Got it.
There it is.
The Commonwealth's a dangerous place.
Brother.
Make sure you gear up before you head out.
So. You're the new recruit I heard about. Not what I was expecting.
What were you expecting?
The last batch of recruits we took on were wastelanders. Dirty, beaten up, looking for a handout. They were desperate and looking for an easy out. You look like you're here for a reason. Anyway, since you came down here to meet me, we may as well get it over with. My name's Ingram. And this lovely little grease pit is where you'll usually find me. If your power armor's too tight in the crotch, the Pridwin's about to crash into the ground, or a robot's gone haywire, you come see me.
Is this where I get my power armor?
Ha! That's always the first question from the new guys. Let's see. I just fixed up a pretty decent T-60 suit. The left leg actuator's a bit sticky, but it'll keep the creeps off of you. It's sitting in Bay 3. There isn't a day that goes by on this tub without 5 or 6 things breaking down. And since I'm stuck in this rig, I'm not quite as spry as I used to be. The work tends to pile up.
You feel like telling me how you ended up that way?
That's a little personal, don't you think?
Most people in your condition would have given up. Can I hear your story?
Sure. What the hell? I was fighting with the Brotherhood in the Capital Wasteland. Worked at a staging area for the Power Armor troops. Our position was along a ridge line overlooking the battlefield. I'd say it was a 100-foot drop, give or take.
You weren't aboard the Pridwin?
The Pridwin wasn't under Maxon's command at the time. It wasn't even in the Capital Wasteland. If she'd had been there, the battle wouldn't have been such a challenge. To make a long story short, the ridge I was standing on took a hit from a nuke, sheared most of the cliff right off, and caused the platform I was standing on to tumble over the side. If I hadn't been test piloting one of the power armor suits at the time, I would have died.
Your power armor helped you survive the fall?
Yeah, it took the brunt of the impact. But I don't know if I'd call it surviving. The suit was trashed after it landed, and I lost both of my legs. Haven't walked since. Anyway, if you need any work done on your power armor, feel free to use the workshops around here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to work.
I'm pleased we were assigned to the same team. I think we can learn a lot from each other.
Proctor Ingram?
Can you tell Kells if he wants things fixed, he needs to keep the damn ship steady?
If Dumb and Ugly had a child, it'd be a super mutant.
Step forward, Knight. Even though they've locked me in this blasted cage, I promise that I won't bite.
Why are you in there?
I'm glad you asked. Now, this is the stowage depot, and I, as you probably already guessed, am the ship's quartermaster, Proctor Tegan. The powers that be have me locked in here, so I can keep an eye on the Brotherhood's valuables. If you need to stock up on supplies before you head out on a mission, this is the place to buy them.
Wait, buy them? Since when does the military sell equipment to its own soldiers?
Since someone dropped a whole bunch of bombs and blew up every single factory that manufactured weapons and ammunition. Keeping the Brotherhood supplied takes caps, and everyone contributes to the cause. The good news is by having a constant flow of caps, I'm able to buy whatever you bring me. Yeah, I'm mostly interested in weapons, but I'll take anything useful. Of course, if you're just looking to make a few caps on the side, I might have some extra work for you to do.
What sort of extra work are we talking about?
Oh, no. It's nothing like you're thinking. It just involves a little bit of heavy lifting and interacting with the local farms. And since I'm stuck up here manning this one-man zoo, I need someone to do the legwork for me. After you're done with the meet and greet, we can discuss the details. In the meantime, if you ever need anything else, gun, a mod, even ammo, you just let me know.
Cade won't clear me for duty yet. I think he's giving me orders.
Ah, good. You're finally here. Just set the books down anywhere. I'll get to them as soon as I can.
What are you doing with all these books?
I suppose I could stop working for a moment to address your question.
Which books contain pertinent information?
Technical volumes, repair manuals, design philosophies, medical research. Anything that enhances the Brotherhood's knowledge. That's why I consider everything else a waste of paper.
Makes sense to get rid of the trash.
Well, I'm pleased you agree. Since it's obvious that you aren't who I was expecting, would you mind telling me why you're here?
Should I come back when you're less busy?
Our recent arrival in the Commonwealth has left me with an immense amount of data to compile. None of that's your fault, really. You're obviously here for a reason. What was it again?
Maxon wanted me to meet the crew. You were next on my list.
Ah, yes. You must be the new recruit described in Paladin Dance's report. Under normal circumstances, I'd provide you with a proper orientation of my department. However, I'm woefully behind setting up research patrols and getting bombarded with requests for technical documentation. Unfortunately, I'm lacking the personnel needed to get the job done.
What type of technical documentation are you looking for?
The Brotherhood is primarily interested in collecting information that might assist us with our current mission. Medical records, science journals, weapon schematics. If it contains any type of useful data, we need to get our hands on it.
What exactly is a research patrol?
Simply put, we send a small two-man team to scout a location and evaluate its technical and historical relevance. Saves us from sending an entire retrieval team to a worthless location.
Maybe I could lend a hand.
That would be splendid. As you patrol the Commonwealth, keep your eyes open for blueprints, memos, manuals, books, charts. Anything containing useful technical data. I'm authorized to pay you for each bundle of documents that you recover. And if you wish to be assigned to a research patrol, I have plenty of them waiting to be filled. In any event, it was a pleasure to meet you, Knight.
Glad you finally stopped by, soldier. Are you ready for your medical exam?
What kind of medical exam? I feel fine.
There's nothing to be alarmed about. I just have a few simple questions about your medical history. It's my responsibility to make sure that you don't bring anything up here that could pose a threat to the crew. I'm going to ask you a series of medical-related questions, and I'd like you to answer me to the best of your ability. First question. As a child, were you ever exposed to radiation for an extended period of time?
Wouldn't Vault-Tec's screening process have caught this already?
Vault-Tec's screening process? Let me check my notes here. You were a vault dweller? You're probably healthier than anyone else aboard. Anyway, sorry I missed that in your records. Just going down the list of questions. I'm sure you understand. Okay, second question. Have you ever had or come in contact with a person confirmed to be carrying a communicable disease?
Have you had problems with the crew catching diseases?
Well, Yes, actually. It's not unusual for our recon teams to stumble across contaminated environments or disease-carrying creatures. We don't want a single crewman infecting the entire ship. Anyway, this exam is about you, so have you had or come in contact with anyone carrying a communicable disease?
Never been seriously sick in my life.
Good, good. Third question. And please, answer honestly. Have you ever had sexual relations with any species considered non-human?
That happens often enough for you to have a question about it?
You'd be surprised how many Wastelanders answer yes to that question. Fortunately, the Brotherhood finds that type of behavior absolutely distasteful. Since you haven't spent too much time in the Wasteland, I'll assume your answer is no. Last question. Would you have any problems pulling the trigger on an enemy of the Brotherhood, whether they're human, formerly human, or machine?
That's more of a morals question, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I feel that the mental state of the crew is just as important as the physical. Anyone that hesitates firing in combat due to misguided moral standards certainly isn't Brotherhood material. So what about you? Would you have a problem with it?
If my life's in danger, I'll do whatever it takes to defend myself.
That's an acceptable answer, and the most common. Excellent. I think I've got all the information I need. I see no reason to prevent you from beginning your duties immediately. If you ever need medical assistance, you let me know.
Familiarized yourself with the Prigment's crew. Are you ready for your next assignment, sister?
What sort of assignment are we talking about?
The kind of assignment where all of the training you've done finally begins to pay off. Let's get right to it then, shall we? Take a look over there. That's Fort Strong, and it's infested with super mutants. Having those aberrations of nature close enough to smell is making me sick to my stomach. To make matters worse, they're sitting on top of a massive stockpile of Fat Man shells we could use in our campaign. I want you to head over there, wipe out everything that moves, and secure that stockpile. Understood?
Super mutants? I thought the enemy was the Institute.
Super mutants are no better than Sentinels. They're a reminder of man's folly when it comes to harnessing technology. Whether it's using biochemistry to manipulate genes, or trying to create life from a bunch of circuits, it's the wrong path for science. As members of the Brotherhood, it's our sworn duty to exterminate these abominations in every form. So, can I count on you to get the job done?
What do these shells do?
The Fat Man launcher is an essential part of the Brotherhood arsenal. It's a miniature nuclear payload in a man-portable format. A squad of troops armed with one of these is virtually unstoppable. If you ever have the pleasure of firing one, allow me to give you a word of advice. Don't fire one of them in close quarters. There won't be enough of you to bury in a shoebox. Is that enough to go on?
Consider it done.
Look, I realize you're eager to take the fight to the Institute, but it'll have to wait. The Brotherhood cannot allow those abominations to have a nuclear arsenal at their fingertips.
It'll be a pleasure to exterminate that mutant filth.
Now, we have a vertibird on standby, fully armed and ready to depart. Use it to carry our message to Fort Strong, and wipe those dirty mutants from the face of the Earth. Dismissed.
Now that you've had a chance to roam the Pridwin, what do you think, Knight?
Where did the Pridwin get her name?
Elder Maxson said he took the name from a work of historical fiction. Something about a man who was destined to become a king. His journey to liberate his people from tyranny and oppression seems fitting for such a remarkable ship, wouldn't you say?
She's very impressive.
Yes. Quite a feat of engineering, isn't she? It took the Brotherhood's sharpest minds over 2 years to design, and more than twice that to build.
Where was the Pridwin constructed?
She was constructed at Adams Air Force Base, just outside of Washington, D.C. There was a vast amount of scrap metal and salvageable components there after we defeated the Enclave. We spent the first 2 years alone gathering the parts. The rest was spent assembling. It was worth the effort.
With the Pridwin in our arsenal, we can mobilize our entire division, sending her anywhere that Elder Maxson wishes her to go.
Her presence in the Commonwealth ensures that our mission to defeat the Institute will end in victory.
Did the Brotherhood ever build other airships?
There were less advanced versions of the ship built on the West Coast a long time ago. Historical records about their current status are in dispute, but we're fairly certain that they were destroyed. In any event, I hope your tour of the Pridwin helped acclimate you to our way of life up here. I think you'll find that the more familiar you become with both her capabilities and her crew, the longer you'll survive as a member of the Brotherhood. You're dismissed, Knight.
I can't believe super mutants were human once. How could science have gone so wrong?
You got all that scribe.
Yeah, research for sure.
Babysitting field scribe. Prestigious.
It's guard duty. Why?
Find a place to set her down and then hightail it back to the Pridwin.
Yes.
What's that? Human! Blood!
There isn't much left to properly identify these remains. Shh. I heard something. Look at this place. You must hate these mutants as much as I do.
Why do you hate super mutants so much?
They're responsible for the death of a close friend, a Brotherhood knight named Cutler. So when you ask if I hate them, I say hate's too gentle a word. These monstrosities are just another example of man blindly taking a step forward, only to wind up stumbling two steps back. I've been fighting for years, trying to put a stop to this madness. And just when I thought we were getting the upper hand, along come the synths. I've seen what these super mutants do to people. Can you imagine what the synths would do to us if they ever got the upper hand? It would be Armageddon repeated, and maybe the end of everything that we hold dear. Look, I don't mean to bore you with my rhetoric. I just want you to understand how important these missions are.
How could synths bring about our destruction?
If the synths reached the point where they outnumbered mankind, how long would it take for them to decide we were no longer necessary? They certainly possess the capability to make more of their own kind, so we'd become expendable. And with Institute technology on their side, nothing could stop them, not even the Brotherhood. It's a nightmare scenario almost too terrible to contemplate. Anyway, that's enough of that. What's important here is that you got the job done and secured these warheads. You should head back up to the Pridwin and talk to Maxon. I'm sure he'll want to debrief you as soon as possible. Dismissed.
Outstanding work at Fort Strong, soldier.
So, what happens at Fort Strong now?
Paladin Dance is supervising the transfer of the Fat Man warheads to the Pridwin. They'll provide quite an edge to our arsenal. I've also ordered a detachment to occupy the location, and use it as a staging area to protect the eastern side of the airport. All in all, you handed us quite a valuable location.
It was an honor fighting for the Brotherhood.
I'm glad you feel that way, because our mission here has only just begun. In order to bring the Institute to its knees, we need to use every weapon at our disposal. I try to supply my soldiers with the best. That's why I'm giving you these. Signal grenades can call a vertibird to your location when you need aerial transport. Simply throw one to the ground, and the vertibird will hone in on the unique electromagnetic smoke it emits. Once you're aboard, use the map on your Pip-Boy to interface with the pilot's navigation system, so he'll be able to take you wherever you need.
Where can I get more signal grenades?
I'd use the supply I gave you sparingly. These devices are far more complex than a standard smoke grenade. Should you need more, you should acquire them from Proctor Teagan.
Will the vertibird stay and help me fight?
I'm afraid I can't spare a fully armed gunship for this task. A standard transport will have to suffice. Of course, nothing's stopping you from using the door gun while in flight.
Thank you, Elder. I'll make good use of them.
I expect that you will. Now, I'm sure you're aware that Fort Strong was simply the first step towards the liberation of the Commonwealth. An even greater task lies ahead. By now, I'm sure you've deduced that our arrival in the Commonwealth wasn't coincidental. We're here because of a unique energy reading recorded by Paladin Dance's recon team. According to our scribes, the reading indicated a level of technology that only the Institute could achieve. The moment this information came to light, our mission became clear. The Institute, and everyone responsible for the creation of the synths, must be eliminated at all costs. To accomplish this goal, we need to locate the Institute's headquarters. I've had our scribes meticulously searching the Commonwealth, but they've come up empty-handed.
Where do I start?
I want you to get out there and become our eyes and ears on the ground. You seem to have a vested interest in locating the Institute before we met, so I'm confident you'll travel in the right circles. If you discover a way in, I need you to report it to me immediately. Any questions, Knight?
Any suggestions on where I should look next?
I'd pursue your lead regarding Dr. Amari. I'm not certain if she's a crackpot, or if she can genuinely assist your search. But our sources say she has some interesting technology at her disposal. Anything else, Knight?
What about those energy readings Paladin Dance's recon team detected?
Our scribes are confident that the energy readings are from Institute technology, due to the unusually high frequency. But the source is unknown. We're still detecting them on occasion. But by the time we send a team to investigate, they disappear. Just watch your step. I wouldn't be surprised if the energy reading were caused by some type of Institute weapon. Is there anything else?
Aren't there any pre-war records about the Institute that might help us?
Our records indicate that the Institute was born from the remnants of a pre-war educational facility, the Commonwealth Institute of Technology. The ruins of the facility are at the center of the city, but we've already searched them thoroughly. The location appears to have been abandoned long ago, so it appears that the trail ends there. Anything else, Knight?
Not right now, Elder.
Very well, then. Dismissed.
Hey, hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
You better back off, or you're the one who's gonna need insurance.
Well, hey, all right. We'll just say your insurance is paid up for now, okay?
Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? She ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn. I said let her go.
You soft handcuff. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something. Why'd you have to go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. Now, I know you had old Finn handled back there, but a mayor's gotta make a point sometimes. You all right?
You're a ghoul?
That's right. Like my face. I think it gives me a sexy King of the Zombies kind of look. Big hit with the ladies. Listen, a lot of walking rad freaks like me around here. So you might want to keep those kinds of questions on the low burner next time. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Good neighbor. That what you call this place?
That's right. We cobbled this little neighborhood together out of the freaks and misfits that just wouldn't be accepted anywhere else. You'll see. You make enough friends here, you'll call this place home soon enough. So long as you remember who's in charge.
In case you're wondering, the Diamond City radio signal comes in loud and clear here in Good Neighbor. And that Travis, man, he got good.
Well, well, Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
You're the one who can extract memories from a brain, right?
Normally, we only allow our clients to experience their own memories. Now, what's this all about?
We need a deep dig, Amari, but it's not gonna be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Isn't there some way to make this work?
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
How much of the brain do you need, exactly?
That is not an encouraging question. I suppose I'll have to make do with whatever you can find.
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Nick's an older model synth. Is he still compatible?
That's exactly what I was thinking. If we are lucky, it should hook right in. But even if this works, Mr. Valentine would be taking on a tremendous amount of risk. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. Let's do it.
You really think this'll work, Nick?
No idea. But we got a missing kid on the line. That's worth the risk.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
How do you lock memories?
The implant is encoding all the mnemonic activity in the hippocampus. Think of it like computer encryption, and we don't have the password. Let's see. A single mind wouldn't be able to crack it. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Any idea of what I'm gonna see in there?
I have no clue. But considering we only have a single piece of the medial temporal lobe and not the whole brain, I doubt it'll be cohesive.
All right, let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.